Now, I know this can be a little excessive for most. Hell, it's a little excessive even for me, and I'm the one doing it. But I want to get the best possible sound for my recordings for this YouTube channel. So this is what I use. Normally when I'm making my videos, I've been using my Zoom H2N recorder with the little foam cover over there, and it's been pretty good. Definitely better than my phone. But I paid close attention to the sound, and I don't think the Zoom H2N is giving me a true enough representation of how my system sounds. I know you guys like the way my system sounds, and I appreciate you guys so much, but it's never going to be like in person, obviously, you know, and my phone is not going to do a good recording, which is why I tried to use the H2N, but, you know, I'm real critical of my system, especially when I'm showing it to you guys, so I decided to use a better mic. I'm going to be using my Shure SM7B, but it's a little excessive because I have to bring all this stuff. Hold on. Uh-oh, phone's in the way. Okay, hold on. Yep, I got to have all this stuff with me, my XLR cables, and I do a podcast, so my Zoom PodTrack P4, all this stuff set up to, yeah, still recording. Yep, make sure I didn't push a button. Yeah, I got to get all this stuff set up in order to get a good recording, but this is my better mic, and I know if I turn the volume up with the H2N, sometime it breaks up a little bit, and I don't think the mics are damaged. And I've got the gain low, just like I have the gain pretty low on the PodTrack for recording, but still, it's not as good as it could be. But what I'm going to do is, going to do a demo, play a couple of songs, and I'm actually going to A and B it. You know, I'm going to play the song with the H2N recording as well as the SM7B recording, and I'm just gonna not blindly bounce between the two. You'll know which one is which, but you should be able to hear a distinct difference between the two. I mean, just on the price alone, this Shure better give me better sound. You know what I mean? I was gonna make a pun with the Shure name, but I'm not gonna. It's just too easy. I'm not gonna do that. But anyway, let's just get to it. I know you don't like me to talk your ear off, so I'm going to go ahead and play a song with this mic. And I usually hold the mic like up here to be close to where my ears are. And I'm going to do the same thing with the Shure. So, yeah, it'll look a little silly with me sitting here like this because I have my camera mounted on my steering wheel now. If you notice, the angle's a little bit different. So if it vibrates, if I play some heavy bass, you know why. But anyway, going to sit here looking silly with this, or maybe I record some B footage and just show you my player or something while I'm doing this. But here we go. All right, and I chose this song because it has pretty good highs, good instruments and all that, and very good mid bass. So here we go.
Can tell each other secrets and remember how to love. Da da dum da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. Da-dum-dum-dum-dum. Da-dum-dum-dum. Da-dum-dum-dum.
FYI, if you're new to the channel, you're unaware, when I do my SQ demos, like those type of songs, R&B or jazz or any type of live performance or anything like that, I usually have my sub bass all the way down. It's tuned to where it's just a little hum, just to fill the car, fill in the sound, and complement the eights in the doors. So a lot of that mid bass, a lot of that hard thumping bass you hear is actually for my doors. Some have sat in my car and thought it might be a little heavy, but I want it to be heavy. You know, I like it heavy. I had 6.5s before I jumped up to 8s because I wanted the 8s to hit harder and heavier than the 6.5s could. Makes no sense for me to go from 6.5s to 8s and have the 8s sound pretty much like the 6.5s, you know? I've been to some SQ shows where they have it tuned that way. Can't say it's good or bad. I mean, just depends on what you like, right? Because at the end of the day, it's for you and for what you like. But for me, I like it to be a little bit heavier. I think I've mentioned before, the reason why I did 8s in the first place was I went to an SQ show and got to hear the Morel SQ Mazda, and it was one of the first cars I've heard in many, many years that had 8 or 9 inch drivers in the front doors. And some have said that his 8s hit a little bit too heavy. Me, I love it, man. He did a demo for me, and I heard a lot of cars there. A lot of cars had 6.5s, and some had 8s, but they weren't tuned like his. His were tuned like subwoofers, like damn near, and it hit hard. And he played a song for me, man, and I literally busted out laughing. Like, I couldn't contain myself because I was the energy that I felt just from the front doors alone. Now, I know they work in conjunction with the sub. It's time aligned, so the rear sub sounds like it's playing up front too, but even when I had mine time aligned with my 6.5s, it just didn't hit the same. I mean, it's a 6.5 versus an 8, so it better hit harder, being that it's an 8-inch driver, right? So, anyway, when you're hearing me do these non-R&B or non-hip-hop songs, that's mostly the 8s kicking in. And I'm going to do a hip-hop track to, you know, let you hear the difference in the sound, and hopefully this microphone will pick it up better than this microphone. But anyway, let me play another SQ type song for you guys just to hear the quality and the mid bass, and then I'll finish it up with one more song that hits a little bit heavier.
Gave you love. I gave you all that I have inside, and you took my love. You took.
It's picking up good. I did a little bit of testing, but not like full-on testing. I kind of do these videos on the fly, so hopefully it's picking up good. If not, you guys rock with me, so you'll rock with me through my journey and trying to get this audio correct. I'll go ahead and finish this video with a little bit of hip-hop, something that hits really, really, really hard, really heavy, and hopefully these mics will pick it up. And please don't mind the vibration on the steering wheel, but my camera's mounted on the steering wheel. I'll probably show you guys maybe some footage at the end of this video. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and play a hip-hop song real quick, and hopefully these microphones do it justice.
No baggage claim. Whole lot of styles, can't even pronounce the name. You ain't got no style, see you on my Instagram. I be rocking it like it's fresh out the pan. Only when I'm taking pics, I'm the middleman. Walk talking like a boss, I just lift a hand. 3 million cash, call me Rain Man. Money like a shower, that's my rain dance. Get me all in black, like it's gangland. Say the wrong words, you be hangman. Pop me stick to your bitch like a spray tan. Mr. What kind of car you in? In the city, love my name. I ain't gotta say it. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Do you let it taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. A lot of girls like me wanna fight me. Nigga, get your ass checked like a fucking Nike. Me not icy. And my bitch want the Fenty, not the Maybelline. I'm the black JB, the way the scream. Make the scream. Pretty little thing. Like AE. Say, yada yeah, that I mean. She can get a taste. She can get a taste.
All right, y'all. Thanks for rocking with me. Thanks for checking out my video. If you like this, please subscribe, share, hit the like button, all that good stuff. And, yeah, man, hopefully this sounded better than my previous videos. If not, I'll keep trying. If it did, now we know we got our settings right. All right, so until next time, stay tuned.